Show up.
Okay, so just like Vince said he would, I'm going to totally steal his show. We're going to talk a lot, so get salty.
Yeah.
Also, disclaimer, guys, this is for your own good, so you don't just watch this and think that we're going to be all nice and pretty about it. We kind of have a big beef with Xbox, so if you want to go and dislike our video and leave, cool. Okay, thanks, bye. For the other people that actually want to hear our opinions, we do try to tear this conference apart, but we don't try to do it in a stupid way. We do try to at least kind of take it with a grain of salt.
There are some things that Microsoft has shown that have interested us. Like, for example, this year, all they need to do, this year all they need to do for me is show off some Cuphead and some Dead Rising 4 and some Sunset Overdrive on the PC, and I'll be all fine with Microsoft.
Yeah, so I mean, we're not gonna completely tear it apart, but we're not gonna be too nice to it. So just so you know, if you want to go ahead and get your dislike over with, fine by me.
Yeah. Hey, it's Zach Ryder.
Also, Zach Ryder, if you're still here, in the description, if you don't want to hear us, you don't have to. Click the link in the description and you get to hear the whole conference without us.
So that annotation at the beginning of the video too, linking you to the conference without our commentary.
But they're probably still going to comment, "You guys talk way too much," even though it's like 3 minutes in the recording.
I bet a lot of them out there just like, by the way.
It's / Xbox.
Oh, it's... Well, I didn't know if it, what the name of it was.
Just / Xbox.
Yeah, I found it. Okay.
It's Ryan, pretty simple. With companies, it's very simple.
Ryan, you know what happens?
What?
I'm pretty sure we get a lot of people like looking for reaction videos, and they see ours, and they just like want to skip ahead to what their favorite announcement was, probably. In the video,
yeah.
And then they just hear us shitting all over it, and they're like, "Wow, what a bunch of assholes!" Instead of actually watching.
You know, that may have been actually what happened.
Yeah.
Wait, because I don't really know anybody that would literally watch this all the way through. But I mean, maybe Nathan Turner will,
because he is a trooper.
Although we haven't really heard from him in a while, so I don't really know if that's a true statement anymore.
Maybe that other guy who stopped talking about how Ratchet's not as good as.
Oh yeah, we're not gonna name drop him because we don't want to give him the satisfaction. But yeah, you suck.
Or that other fucking schmuck.
We're talking about the same guy.
Oh, we're on.
If you happen to be watching this video, Mr. Person who will not be named, Ratchet is indeed an asshole in the first game, and you can't convince anyone otherwise.
Yeah, and kind of from your channel, you don't really have too much of an opinion on us, so just saying. Especially with who you associate yourself with. Anyway, that's enough time. I think that was like 2 minutes. All right, that's enough.
Fuck your special.
Let's do bingo.
All right.
All right. Oh, freak. I don't have my bingo. Where's my bingo?
I just linked it.
I need to
save it.
I need to save it. Dude. All right, hold on. I don't even have it in GIMP right now. All right, this is brilliant. Okay. Shoot, I thought that it was them starting, but that was the stream stuttering. Okay, bingo. We have Long Dead Franchise comes back and doesn't suck. Something Dumber Than the Car being on stage last year. Only on Xbox One and PC. Remember Kinect, please. Surprise, Phantom Dust is still being made. Backwards compatibility for days. Windows 10. Phil Spencer back again with a hip new shirt. That's definitely going to get marked. Sea of Thieves details. Scalebound gets a stable frame rate. Indies! New Dead Rising that nobody asked for. Hey, I asked for it. Free Space.
Dead Rising.
Halo 6 gets a teaser and nothing else. Microsoft and Oculus partner up. Info about a game from a company who already has a conference. Remember HoloLens, please? Yeah. New Xbox dashboard update. Upgraded Xbox One model actually exists. Con Man's Recore shows up. New Gears of War because making new IPs is hard. Yet another Forza game, oh boy. Exclusive Minecraft content. Long dead franchise gets a conquer gets the conquer treatment.
To everyone affected
and
by the recent
new Killer Instinct
Orlando,
stuff. Crowd is unfortunately uninterested.
And you should know you are not alone.
Hey, we're
the
going.
The gaming community mourns with you.
They're doing an Orlando tribute.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
That's classic. Also, I do like that guy's shirt. Though. He's wearing
oh man, EDM.
He's kind of hiding his ribbon though.
Oh man, check out
this. It's like
music.
More of a badge. It's not exactly a ribbon.
Okay, well, it was licensed music on a bingo card because we can already totally pick that.
No.
I think licensed music is on the Sony bingo card.
Damn it.
Well, yeah, because we kept getting. That's the reason why we keep getting claimed, is because of the freaking music.
Sunset Overdrive. Give it to
us. Hey, it's the new Xbox that got leaked already.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Xbox!
This one lets you put it vertically.
A Space Odyssey.
This one what?
This one can be set up vertically.
It's the
Xbox One Slim.
You mean just like the PS4 first model did?
Way to steal from Apple, you fucking assholes.
No, the PS4 first model, you can't put it... Well, you can, but it doesn't work. Might as well.
No, I'm gonna... Slimmer. I'm gonna be my usual self and say, guys, let's give him a chance.
Guys... 40% it's a... Whoa! I was about to say, so it's less of a VCR now.
Up to 2 terabytes internal HDD.
This is actually...
Okay.
Integrated power supply.
Let me just be that guy and say, why didn't they do this with the first model?
Because then they wouldn't be able to do this.
HDR gaming.
Hey, we can put montage down.
Man,
look at all these hype Xbox.
That's not one.
4K!
Offer HD video on Blu-ray.
I still don't know what House of Cards is about.
The new Xbox wireless controller.
Ooh.
Textured grip. Xbox wireless and Bluetooth.
I love how Vince is being our...
Okay, no offense though, I don't think range was a problem. How much farther back do you need to play?
I need to be able to play this in my backyard.
Yeah, I need to have like the TV set, an Xbox set on top of my house, and I need to play it from my neighbor's house.
Phil Spencer. I mean, it's. I actually have to say.
What shirt are you wearing this year, man?
What is he wearing? What do we got?
Is
it him? I don't see it yet. Is it just literally? Oh, it's the first Xbox logo, isn't it?
That's hip. That's hipster.
Is that hip?
Ooh, that's that. Huh.
One S. They're really pulling an Apple.
That's what I said.
If they call it a freaking no, but I didn't know what the name was.
Welcome you to what I believe is going to be a special show for us, our fans. And what we expect to be another great
E3 for
the industry.
I refuse to call it Xbox anymore. From now on, I will now refer to it as Xbox.
And welcome to the millions watching us around the world. Today,
I
we will show
to say
you
the
how
Xbox
we are creating
One
more
S
choice
does actually kind of
in your gaming
impressive.
Experience than ever before.
So, Matt,
more
are you going to start opening? So, Matt,
on Xbox Live,
because of the joke with Apple,
course,
are you going to start opening or fixing those that I dropped?
Yeah, fuck off.
Xbox so One S repair, Matt, you can do it. It's the same as repairing an iPhone.
No, it's not.
Please welcome from the Coalition.
No, it's not.
Studio head, Gears co-creator, my friend.
Oh man, Coalition.
Zane, have you tried repairing consoles before?
Yes.
Rod Ferguson.
Matt would just flounder and die.
Hey, Rod Ferguson, whoever that is.
Where is Cliffy B?
Oh man, Gears of War 4.
Where's Clifford?
No, man, he's
new Gears of War. Guys, we got one. Guys, we got one.
New
Gears of War because making new IPs are hard.
This icon means when you buy the game digitally.
So we got one already.
Oh, Xbox Play Anywhere.
Xbox One and Windows 10 PC.
Oh, hey, it's the same thing Sony did like 4 years ago.
Yeah.
So is this Windows 10?
Yes.
All Microsoft always playing catch up to Sony.
And shared across both platforms.
Okay, we're putting Windows 10.
No additional cost to you.
I would hope not. And don't pull any
I would hope not. That would be a very bad idea.
This, October, this new feature, Play Anywhere, also known as Crossplay, over on the Sony.
Okay, well, every co-op mode in that game supports Crossplay. So,
so wait, does this count only on Xbox One and PC yet?
Yes.
Okay. Wow, right out of the gate, we've got three.
Shit, wait a second. Here's a question.
Yeah.
So you can do you can do crossplay from so if I have a friend playing Xbox One playing whatever and I'm playing on PC, that will work?
Yeah.
Oh my god, then I don't have
Laura Bailey.
I was really getting upset because all my friends are having Xboxes. I'm like, "Oh, I want to play with you guys."
I'm excited to show off the campaign.
But now I can just do this. This is brilliant.
Kate's mother, Raina, has been abducted by a monstrous new threat, the Swarm. And it's up to our team to save her.
Okay, so are we in agreement? Is the shirt hip?
Xbox One and Windows 10.
I mean, it's retro.
Hipster. It is hipster.
Okay, it's hip then.
He's wearing the original Xbox,
There's the Windows 10 exclusive. See, now nothing is exclusive to Xbox anymore, so it kind of hurts them a little bit.
Well, not really, because they get money either way.
I know, but I'm just saying, it's more of a reason to not buy an Xbox.
And lists today. Oh no, the Locust.
That's all I'm saying. It's more of a reason to not get it.
Considering that a Windows 10 key costs almost as much as the new Xbox One is going to, I don't say it matters very much. I say
we wait it out. We can't. Not if we're gonna save Raina.
So you just have to buy the game though, and then how does that work? Do you get a code or?
Yeah, you get a code for the Windows 10 store.
Check it out.
Yeah, it's just like the Windows 10 store.
Look, guys, it's the gameplay.
Actually, no, this doesn't look too bad, but I'm not really impressed yet.
Well, particle effects for that are...
Okay, that's actually impressive. I'm impressed a little bit more now.
Vault over that cover. Oh man, it's Pyramid Head over there. Look, guys, it's Pyramid Head.
Wait, when does Windows 10 become not free anymore?
Like
July
another
something?
Month. Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Just, I can see Pyramid Head busting a move up there.
Ooh.
This isn't Just Dance yet. This isn't Ubisoft.
Is it Vince, what is that knife made of? Lasers? No, but, so wait, we're good though with Windows 10 though, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. I always get
If you already, if it's already linked to your account, you're fine.
It should be, but I just get scared.
I'm still not sure if I should put it on my laptop yet.
This turret is fucking terrible. I know,
but I'm hoping it's fine. Yeah, that guy can't fucking hit anything.
Let's move this big hunk of junk while we're being shot at.
Are they gonna try to?
Oh, now he is.
A catapult? Oh my god.
They're actually getting hit in the demo.
We're getting medieval up in this bitch.
So, Xbox did not learn from Bethesda and is doing live demos.
They're doing live demos with Laura Bailey and Ted Ferguson.
I wouldn't say that the live demos by itself are bad.
Buy one,
I would
on
say...
both Xbox One and Windows 10.
Well, I'm just saying there's room for error.
Yeah. Like, don't be like Nintendo, because they did a live demo of a thing-based... with their wireless controller system.
Right? Oh god, yeah.
Oh, that's right.
And then it got fucked up by cell phone interference. Because they hadn't fixed it yet.
Oh, that's fucking
But of course the technology's enhanced enough to where it's not as bad.
Yeah, now they've gotten it all ironed out. It's like, whatever.
Oh, you're talking about like the Wii?
Yeah, the Wii. They did a live Wii demo, and the cell phone interference fucked it up. Help me
with this. You know, with this environment here, this kind of feels like what would happen if Microsoft owned and made Doom.
Yeah, a little bit.
You're probably not wrong.
No.
Well,
this is
let's
make a Doom-ish kind of game.
I mean, new IPs are hard, but technically Doom isn't a new IP, so.
This I can use. Oh man, a chainsaw, skin your ass wrong.
No, it's a fucking... Look at this. It's the buzz blade.
Okay.
I have to say...
You literally just shot yourself with it.
I No, but guys, in any kind of game where there's guns, I love the kind of weapon where you can just shoot buzz blades at people.
You mean any unconventional shooting method? Pretty much. Anything that isn't a gun?
It has to be like, no, it has to be specifically like these kind of buzz blade deals.
Oh, I thought you were talking about like basically anything that isn't a gun is cool. Cause guns are boring.
Cause fucking buzz blades just shoot and they spin and they bounce and they tear and it's all just a magic.
I mean, cause conventional guns are boring now.
Fucking yeah. Red as shit.
There's like a buzz blade type weapon like this in like most of the recent Ratchet and Clank games, and they're always my favorite weapon to get and use.
So this is video game logic, right? But how far in the demo do you think, if this was real life, we would all be dead?
Probably the first... Probably the first 20 or 30 seconds.
That depends on how fast you find me, or, you know, and
when, when did the first enemy show up? Probably before the demo started. We would probably not make it on screen.
No, Matt, Zane... In real life, we would have to journey to you, and then...
Oh my god, lightning.
You guys would die before you even...
And then we would die instantly. It's like a Left 4 Dead journey situation.
One thing that's really cool is that when you can use the environment to kill people, but it's not obvious. Like, it's just... Like, you shoot a barrel and you loosen shit up. So you don't know, though, if it's gonna help you or hurt you. It's kind of cool.
Okay, I'm sorry. I know they're trying to look professional and everything with the cutting away to a camera thing, but it's kind of annoying.
Yeah.
Oh man, get in there. Oh shit, what's all
oh,
shit?
Hey.
Oh, it's a big guy.
Hey, oh, hi!
That looks like a Doom boss.
It looks like a Hell Baron.
I don't even know what that is. I can't even describe it.
I'm 90% sure that's one of the... enemy types in Doom.
By the way, guys, there's no shirt, guys, so this conference is automatically disappointing.
Well,
then.
Hello.
Thank oh,
you.
Hi.
We're getting my mother back.
Hey, you look like what's her face from Fallout 4. You look like the Piper
chick. They muted her.
Oh, yep. Did she like say stuff?
Yes,
oh,
she said stuff that they can't apparently repeat.
Ah, she said naughty words.
She kind of looked like an older Max to me.
Older
Max Caulfield.
She sounded like
older,
Chloe,
more badass, man.
I mean, but, like has similar freckles.
Is this Guillermo del Toro's another fucking home, game? James.
So she kind of looked like Max to me.
Oh,
hey!
Joel!
Shit.
Holy shit, Joel! You let yourself go.
It's Joel. Oh god,
man.
That's fucking what's
October?
Marcus.
Wow.
Don't
stop. Marcus. Keep going.
No, that was
Joel. Right. Can you mark anything else? I don't think so.
It's the elite controller. Totally, we need that.
Hey, look, there's blood and dirt on it.
Oh,
it
man.
Makes it cool.
Hey.
Oh, is this gonna be a special Xbox?
Special Xbox and a special Xbox controller.
Oh man, the
that actually looks
kind of
cool, but at the same time,
now.
I wouldn't actually want to touch
yeah,
it.
Yeah, pre-order now. Give us community
manager. Yeah, give us
the
money early. $130 controller.
Where did he come from? My gosh!
Killer Instinct. Yes, I love this game.
I want to start by saying thank you to the nearly 7
okay,
million.
Okay, but the crowd has to be uninterested.
And so far, they seem interested.
Your passion is what has made KI. The most
I bought
fighting game on
$60
Xbox
worth of KI stuff day
it's
one.
It's because of you that we brought KI to Windows 10 in March. And we're absolutely blown away to say that since then.
I don't really understand why this person put the crowd
Xbox
is unfortunately uninterested
10.
Because
it's
they're going to be.
Of you that we've brought in incredible guest characters like Rash from Battletoads.
Oh, they did?
Yeah, Battletoads, yeah.
Yeah,
and
Rash is pretty good and Arbiter's
quite
okay.
Done yet. So it's time for our next character to emerge.
Aww.
A special gift out there for all
of
you.
Oh man,
fans.
It's gonna be the
and
main character
to
from Sunset
fight.
Overdrive.
Oh god,
Xbox
we got a Gears.
One.
Crash Bandicoot.
Oh wait, was
no.
So,
no.
Shut the fuck
how
up.
How much of this was already leaked?
No, Banjo-Kazooie.
This part none.
Yeah, Banjo-Kazooie for Killer Instinct.
I'm calling it now.
No, he already said it was a Gears of War character.
Oh, it's a pack of locusts.
We're not the pack of locusts, Vince. I'm not the pack of locusts, Vince.
General Ram, holy shit.
General Ram.
Oh, settle it and smash.
You know, with all these special guest characters they're introducing, this game is basically becoming like Microsoft All-Stars.
No.
Yeah. Maybe.
Athletris, let his own throw for Christ's sake.
Although, I don't really know.
Oh, hey, Vince, we gotta play Killer Instinct now.
Xbox One. And
Windows
10
we gotta play as the Gears of War.
Character. As if you weren't gonna play it before.
Oh. Oh, hey, it's a thing.
Xbox One.
What's this? Look at that water. It's good water.
So,
look at
these they, should have an, good trees. They should have a footnote whenever they say exclusive. They should have a footnote whenever they say exclusive.
Right
and
right
then
now.
Say.
I'm gonna call it Forza.
Rainbow Six. No, Tom, some
guys,
Wildlands or something.
No. Every time they say Windows 10 or Xbox and Windows 10 exclusive, they should go ahead and put a footnote that says for a while.
Yeah.
So you can check off Forza.
Yeah. Hey, look,
what was Forza? I know what. Did I say Forza? I think I did. Oh yeah, another Forza game. Oh boy.
Yeah.
That looks like the Buffalo Bill symbol.
Gotta love that Forza. That.
Shoot, which one did I... Oh, this one.
I'm horribly disinterested in this Forza. And every Forza. You know, I don't really like sports.
I got one. It's a pretty good game.
I mean,
if you're
racing games to me...
And you are not interested in Forza, then good for you. You should play The Crew instead.
I thought that wasn't very good either.
Yeah, one thing
it
you
had it
know,
made
though,
some
like,
very poor geography
really
choices.
Oh, okay.
Like Arizona is like
really
one town.
See, my problem with racing games is it's all
Forza
the same.
Forza Horizon 3.
It's literally
I didn't even
the
know
same
they made
thing.
Horizon 2 for Christ's sake.
I didn't even know they made a Horizon.
Oh man, Ralph Fulton. Can we pull him his ass out of here?
Good morning.
No.
And well,
Playground Games sounds a little weird.
It is great to have the opportunity today to show
oh man,
you the
Australia.
Beauty and the action-packed fun of Forza Horizon 3. I'm joined on stage today
Crikey,
by Martin,
look at this.
Our world
Gata. Actually, is Nikki still here?
Please welcome Karen, who'll be playing on
no,
Xbox One S
oh.
in HDR. She'll be driving
Oi.
My favorite BMW
Rockin',
M4.
Mate.
Customized with
guys right
hey, mate.
And HDR.
Hey, mate. Where's the Gator?
4K Windows 10 PC with his favorite
okay,
wheel.
I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry, guys. Watching. I'm not being.
And Terrence, also on PC.
Insensitive. I actually love Australian accents.
Ideally suited
yeah.
for some of Australia's most extreme.
We got Chile on the Xbox One.
Just,
and
they all remind me
on the fucking
the
wheel. And we got some other two cunts on the
Every Australian reminds me of Steve Irwin.
Edit that out, Barry.
Yeah.
Please.
Yeah. No. Not.
Yeah. Please. Though.
Zane's not doing anything.
No. I'm not.
Hey, Macaws.
Through its
hey,
it's
a
card game.
Hey, look,
it's guys.
Like every racing game fucking ever.
So how have your has Karen your day been, guys? What's up with you guys?
Pretty good, I guess. I mean, I woke up way too early for Microsoft's press conference.
We're getting way too hyped over Microsoft. I'm giving Microsoft a bit of the doubt still.
No, I know, but this is kind of our break round because, Matt, do you really have anything interesting to say about Forza?
I did buy a Forza game once.
Why would you
Why?
Well, no, I got it for Christmas.
We have taken the horizon.
Oh, okay, that doesn't count.
To Australia.
You
well,
didn't
I
buy
to
it.
See.
You got
I
it.
I love how your thoughts on this
most
Forza game are. I bought a Forza game
built.
Once.
And it's just like, yeah,
they
see?
Are,
even
they are
even more proving my point. Even
terrain,
more proving my... No, but okay, my beef
with
racing games is that it's literally the same thing every time. There's nothing innovative about it.
Yeah.
To say well, the environments look pretty good.
Forza yeah, the environment, like that's the thing. The graphics,
the graphics improve.
Yeah.
The graphics improve, but that's about it.
See, there's the thing. I think that. When it comes to racing games, I think what they should do is not have so many so quickly because there's not enough to update with.
Yeah.
If you space it out, then the graphics and the environments look better.
It's like a new iPhone.
Yeah, it is. Like, okay, the first one was pretty impressive, but after the 75th, you're kind of getting, like, seeing okay.
Can we get that robot racing thing? It was an anime, like, forever ago. On their way to the beach. IGPX?
Actually,
yeah, that. Can we get a modern game of that?
You know what?
That was interesting.
You know what I want to come back? And I'm really, I really don't know what happened to it.
Star Wars Combat Racing?
No, Vince will agree with me on this immediately when I say it, but they should get back to the Burnout series.
Yes.
Like, what happened to those, Zane?
I think the company got bought or something. I don't know.
Because I would love to see a Burnout with these graphics.
Yes, please.
Well, then they'd have to do damage modeling and then make it explode, and you know, that's hard.
But... they're able to make a Forza game.
Yeah, they can make a Forza game. They can and explode and have fire effects.
I know, but Burnout though. And Windows. Okay, seriously, you can't say that to me and say that there aren't other games with explosions and dented stuff.
No, but I'm saying that whoever owns them aren't gonna.
Oh man. Oh, is this Recore?
You know, it might be Recore.
Who actually owns Burnout? Actually,
I don't know. Somebody Google now. It.
Burnout.
Jewel.
Oh, that's right. It was Criterion.
Yeah, Criterion. They made Criterion that Need for Speed game once for fucking EA.
What's this?
Oh, that's right. It's EA. So, what I don't understand is why did they stop the Burnout series, but they kept going with the Need for Speed series?
I don't
know. Because it's EA. EA's dumb, yeah.
I would, because, like, the last Burnout game was into... Actually, what was the last Burnout game?
Is this that Horizon?
Burnout Paradise.
No.
Oh, yes.
Recore, Matt.
Yeah,
I don't know
Recore.
Games.
See, that one wasn't that good.
I didn't hear about this game.
Man. I would like them to go back to like Burnout Revenge or Burnout Takedown.
Yeah, Burnout Revenge is really good. I really enjoyed that one.
But holy like crap, the cool. The Paradise was it didn't do it for me.
This
it really
looks
didn't.
Pretty cool.
Oh my god, Bastion.
Oh my god, it kind of does look like Bastion.
Actually, you know what? I didn't check out how Bethesda did. Did you guys post it to the page? I'm guessing no.
I uploaded it. You know the description is just hashtag shirt guy, right?
I don't care.
I didn't do the description.
I already made
it. Oh my god, is that the Game of Thrones robot?
Oh man.
This is pretty cool.
Yeah, Recore looks really good.
Recore.
Xbox Play Anywhere. Oh my god, that means it's coming
Survival
to PC too! Vince, Recore's on PC.
Yeah.
Now I think ladies and gentlemen, from Square Enix, game director
Hajime Hatamoto. We'll probably get you a new
senior hey!
Oh, Final Fantasy 15.
Hajime, yeah. I heard Final Fantasy 15 was going to be at Xbox today.
You got Squeenix, everybody.
Yeah, Squeenix.
Squeenix.
Show us King's Play, Final Fantasy 15.
In the movie?
Wild yeah, the Final movie Fantasy with the fucking 15. Ridiculous looking really good CG.
We are excited to show you the first ever demo.
I'm just gonna steal
Xbox
the
Smart.
Tags that I had for last year.
I will be played by Matt. It will be played by Matt. Take it away, Matt.
Thank you, Tabata-san.
Yeah.
Before we move on to
yeah,
the gameplay, I would like to explain a little
gameplay.
Bit about the demo we're about to show. What we're about to see is the Trial of Titan. Noctis and his allies are being tested by the gigantic Titan. But while they're fighting, the opposing army joins the fray, setting up a chaotic
oh,
three-way
man.
Battle.
And Titan, are we about to
we're
play Shadow of the Colossus?
We're excited to show how fast and fluid the battle system is in Final Fantasy 15, which has never been achieved in any of our previous titles. Now, let's move on to the demo.
Ooh. Whoops.
I have this game pre-ordered.
I just realized what I did wrong.
Holy shit, it's Shadow the Colossus.
Oh my god, it's Doomsday.
Oh my god, you show him, Sasuke.
Yes, he felt like Sasuke.
Oh, mate, slice his hand. That's super intense, son.
Oh, yeah, okay, so I'm literally just gonna steal.
Hey, look,
I'm
look steal it's Final Fantasy 15, the Shadow of the Colossus.
Oh man, it's Final Fantasy Hearts.
So I've already played this, right? For the Platinum demo, because you got
it's
a special
Kingdom
summon
Final
if you
Fantasy.
Beat it.
He's getting punched in the face! How is this guy living?
Because he's magic.
Yeah, magic.
Wow. Beautiful, guys.
Yes.
Beautiful sync.
This game is really good, though.
But Zane, doesn't his character design remind you of Doomsday?
A little bit, yeah.
Better than fucking.
Oh, you got fucked, Noctis.
Better than fucking that asshole decided to make. Zack Snyder decided to make him look in Batman vs. Superman.
Oh, come on, Noctis. Haven't you played Shadow of the Colossus before? You have to get on the Hydra's back.
What the
get up on the Hydra's
really?
Back!
Really, Vince?
Get up on the Hydra's back!
So what do you think, guys? What do you think of this game?
It exists.
Pretty good.
I honestly it don't exists. Give a, I don't give a shit about the
Thanks,
Final
Matt.
Fantasy series. I'm sorry. I really don't care.
Thanks, Matt. For the
I appreciate what they've done for the video game community. I think everyone likes them. I just don't care.
Matt just doesn't care.
I'm sorry. Being honest here. Okay. Whoever's playing this demo, I feel like has never played this game before because I'm like they don't they,
yeah.
they look
it's
like
a
they're
live
doing
demo. Really what do you think is going to happen?
I know, but don't you think the guy should know how to play the fucking level?
You're showing off the battle system really well, Philip, by getting your ass kicked.
Hello. I mean.
Oh shit.
E3 special
Titan,
mission.
Special mission.
Wow. Fucking wow.
Come on, Sasuke, just hit him with that Chidori.
How long is this gonna go on for?
Well, the conference is 90 minutes, so you know.
I know, but Jesus!
They gotta show off that combat.
That's never before.
And that guy's just standing there like, this looks good.
This photo, holy shit, what the hell is this? That one battle in Naruto where they had to fight what's his face in the water village?
Why do they. Oh my god, wow. Oh man. He lost a fucking hand.
Yeah,
and it's
fuck
over.
You, Haku. Your miss is in.
Alright, that wasn't that bad. I thought that was
available
gonna...
Vince, September 30th.
I think they're making zero progress.
Thank you, Map. That was great.
Hey, I can't help it if this motherfucker looks a lot like Sasuke.
September 30th.
Sasuke.
Thank you for watching and have a great day. Thank you.
Yay.
So I really didn't expect to see Final Fantasy at Xbox's conference.
They gotta bring
how much did Microsoft pay?
Ubisoft, hey! Showing off a game from a company that already has a conference.
They
check that off the
control
big.
Over the underground of New
Watch
York,
Dogs
and
2.
Preparing to hit us again.
Yeah.
It
get
looks
ready.
Like it.
And
yeah,
take the
Watch
fight
Dogs
to
2.
Them.
I didn't even see the Watch Dogs 2 trailer, but I was already able to tell.
Yeah, I haven't seen it either. Wait, is this the Division?
No, wait.
This is the Division.
No, yeah, it's the Division.
Yeah.
It's okay. Yeah, that game
that
sunk
that
terribly.
94% of their
fucked
off.
And yet they're still trying to. I'm surprised that this bingo card doesn't have something Division on it.
But the bingo card does have the freaking thing that says they're showing off a game from a company that already has a conference later. So.
Yeah.
Oh, who is this?
Ubisoft.
Oh, okay.
The Division Underground expansion. Oh, man.
Oh, that's right. We I didn't do the,
is there something about DLC? Dice.
Patrick I didn't do the upgraded model. Okay,
Patrick
so I'm marking that.
Brian, is there something about DLC?
Oh, Battlefield.
Please, oh for Christ's sake, please let that be cross
our team's ambition was to deliver
because then I don't have to fucking buy an Xbox
for you.
And I still won't, but still.
You already have one.
No, my brother has one.
I know, but you can still leech off of him.
Are you kidding me? He'll never. He's an asshole.
World War One.
Okay, so
this is another game that was already shown off. So, geez, cross it off twice.
The most dynamic battlefield we've ever created.
Uh-huh. Yeah, it's an EA game.
From epic 64-player experiences to dramatic.
So we can't do Killer Instinct, unfortunately.
No battle is ever the same.
Well,
because the crowd had to have been unfortunately interested or uninterested.
To create an ever-changing world.
Yeah, they cared.
And it's more immersive than ever before. You will be able to play when Battle 1 launches on October 21st. But
when did Gears War 3 come out?
Gears of War 3.
Yeah.
Aw, oh, man.
Like,
what about
more than 3 years ago?
About crossplay,
yeah, definitely
Patrick.
More than 3 years ago.
So, do we count that as long dead franchise comes back and doesn't suck?
Oh, look, another.
I don't think so.
No. Okay.
It had
the same,
games
the same trailer again.
Jesus Christ.
This is the third time we've seen this trailer.
The third time we've seen this. Holy
oh, wait. Was that Recore that we saw?
Yeah.
That was Recore.
Yeah.
Oh, we can mark that then.
Man, I really played first on Xbox One, yeah, so I'm guessing. I'm gonna take a wild guess and say this isn't.
Wow, guys. So we already
Xbox
have
Xbox everywhere, wherever the fuck that's called.
We already have eight marked.
Eight marked.
Damn,
crap.
Jesus Christ.
Not Man. Counting Free Space.
Yes, yeah, yes, guys. This
yeah,
looks really good.
Yeah, it looked really good yesterday.
I know, but now I get to
and
see
now
it
looks like
I'm
crap.
I'm actually happy because I get to see it in real time. Because before
it looked good yesterday, but now it looks like crap.
You know what? We're probably gonna see this at the PC conference, and we're probably gonna see it at the Sony conference because EA probably wants to get their money's worth for this expensive-looking trailer probably put together.
Yeah.
Well,
probably.
I mean, the game's already expensive enough, so
there's probably zero chance
that
you can cross.
They gotta make
PC
their money's worth
Xbox
out of this fucking song they licensed. Doesn't fit with one.
Yes, they do. They need to show the people that they're hip and cool and they want to connect with the gaming community with good stuff.
Okay, so to make bingo, there's only two ways to get bingo right now. We need a dashboard update and Minecraft content, or HoloLens and dashboard.
Well, we're totally gonna get dashboard. I'm
Please welcome
it.
Head of Platform Engineering, Mike Ibarra.
Hey, look, it's the dashboard update.
Mike Ibarra.
In 2002,
Xbox Live.
We launched Xbox Live, where anyone playing
wow.
any type of game
wow.
can group up to make
we,
new
this
friends.
This is impressive that we're fucking talking about
world.
Dashboard, and he's probably
Your
about to talk about
to play more has let us
GG.
Invest continually in Xbox Live.
Building a faster, more reliable,
he has a
around the world.
Where gamers are.
He's special. He has a pen
in a
instead
faster,
of a ribbon.
More reliable
oh.
network.
A lot of actually, a lot of people today. Have
Xbox
had
Live
pens.
Was built by the passion
oh, really?
Of millions.
Yeah.
Of fans.
I haven't been paying attention.
Listening to your feedback is one of the most important things
this guy
we do.
Is deep fucking
it
voice.
It has inspired us to deliver on Xbox One backward compatibility. To bring you the new Xbox One experience.
Oh, man.
You can't
backwards compatibility for days, guys.
Hey, look, guys, new Xbox One experience.
One,
backwards
one
compatibility
games,
for days.
Rocket League recently enabled this across all of the networks.
Oh, man, Rocket League.
Your feedback drives us every day. And because of it,
I love
we're
that
excited
Rocket
to bring
League was the first
new
one to
features
do that.
To Xbox One this summer, like background music. So you can listen
yeah, new dashboard
to
update.
Ah, background music. Create your own
okay.
soundtrack.
Right, we're marking dashboard.
That's kind of cool.
You choose your preferred
language region
no matter
independent.
Where you live.
Yeah, but you can literally do that in your house anyway.
Hey,
we're getting Cortana.
Hey, Cortana.
Xbox Live is available
yeah.
on whatever device.
You know, I haven't used her in a while.
PC,
does she actually work
an
now?
Xbox console,
eh.
an iOS
Xbox
or
Live
device.
Was on your device.
Now. I want to talk about three of the most requested features that will be coming this fall and available for every game and every gamer. First,
DVR?
Xbox Live has a great diversity of gamers representing different playstyles, interests, mm-hmm. and genres. The challenge is finding uh-huh. people with shared interests and having a place to talk about the games we love. Today, I am pleased to announce clubs on Xbox Live.
Oh, fuck you.
Like a message board?
Xbox Reddit.
That love the same things you do.
It's Xbox Edit, it's Xbox 4chan, it's Xbox every message board ever.
I'm sorry, this is kind of
dude, this is like freaking Hubs on Steam. This is Steam Hubs, guys.
It needs to be easier to
this is Steam Hubs slash groups.
So I'm excited to announce looking for group on Xbox Live.
Oh, hey.
It's like a wall looking for group. Multiplayer.
Oh,
and it's
man.
The simplest way to find other game
LFG.
Such innovative features.
It's like, hey, he's just like looking for a job and you put out your resume. Well, I got, I had a game where I went 50 and 4 in Call of Duty. I'm a 12th prestige.
So wait, did this count?
Like,
oh,
this
no, wait. Never mind. This doesn't count as.
Whether
Minecraft
you're a
content.
Pro or a casual
well,
gamer,
I mean,
we want to unleash competitive gaming for everyone.
It's not exclusive Minecraft content.
It's actually on Xbox Live. It's even okay.
I'm stretching it.
Arena on Xbox Live.
This now, this. This is cool.
Actually, that's see, that's going in the right direction.
Yeah. Or with your friends in your favorite games.
That's
except I'm personally, I'm not knocking them, but I'm personally uninterested because I would never do any of that.
Wargaming and
hey, Daybreak.
H1Z1, what the fuck?
You can't talk about competition without mentioning EA.
Hey, look, those games I haven't played.
So today, we're excited to announce that EA will be bringing some of their biggest
games.
Yep,
this is all for Matt.
To Arena in the coming years.
Oh man, massive FIFA.
So starting this fall,
why would they put FIFA first?
Living the
why
dream,
would
Vince.
Find the people you want to play with using Looking
I
for Group.
Can't wait for
and
to play FIFA
the
Effect
best tournaments
Andromeda.
In Arena.
CLA.
Xbox Live.
Looking for Group
in
Arena is a really good idea. Looking for Group is not that bad, and the other one's kind of dumb.
Looking for Group is literally just like what they should have already had.
Minecraft, here it is!
Wow! We're just Sacks.
With over 100
so
million players
that's what Jimmy
on
wishes he was named.
Platforms, the Minecraft community is one of the biggest in gaming.
We
until now,
so
guys,
mad if I'm muted
to
right
easily share and connect.
So guys, guess what?
Unless they were on the same platform.
Guess what, guys?
Today, we have bingo already.
We have bingo.
Wow.
With Xbox
amazing.
Live for the first
and if they mention Hollow,
hey, Minecraft is not crossplay.
Windows 10. Can easily play the game online and share the world with their friends.
Probably not with modded servers, though.
No.
Stax just looks a little
excited,
like...
I'm still waiting on servers to be cross-play.
No matter what device they play on. So we're calling today's release...
Because that would be interesting.
Because this is
congratulations,
our
Microsoft, on
ever.
Being very predictable.
Connecting with your friends on different devices is cool.
Friendly update.
What's even cooler...
She had to stop herself from laughing when she said that.
Did you see that? Yeah.
So that they can play with you, even when you're
I'm
the person
still
doing
waiting
the presentation
on.
Can't say it with
realms,
a straight face, you fuck
you can play with your friends.
Well, I'm still waiting on... PC servers to be console compatible.
Minecraft Realms.
Let's jump in and
nobody
check it
cares
out, Zach.
About Realms that I know of.
Welcome. Because
Realms
Realms
is basically just a paid server. You're basically just paying for a server.
Minecraft.
I didn't even know they had it on the iPad. Besides, like Pocket Edition.
So he's playing on the iPad, and she's playing on a Surface.
The reverse.
But still,
the reverse.
Did that just for the achievement.
Yep,
a diamond, yeah,
Xbox
achievement.
Live achievement on an iPad on stage at E3. Okay, let's keep going.
Wow.
It's great coming back.
Revolutionary.
That was really terrible. She had to fight through those words. Did you notice that?
Yeah.
Both of them are like, you can tell both of them are like, Jesus Christ, this is hard.
Just the perfect friend here.
No, like, I bet you anything, guys. I bet you anything, they drew
this. He's on an Oculus.
They drew this. They drew the short straws before the conference. They're like, okay, guys, who's going
to
be the Minecraft guys?
Minecraft world.
Nobody wants to do it? Okay, fine. We'll draw straws.
The most important gaming application.
Hey, no, he's using, like, a fucking cell phone.
Spin around, take in everything.
Yeah, no, he's using a gear.
That's the Galaxy.
Like,
so Lydia, what do you have to show me in your
mobile phone?
No, but I'm talking about the phone. I'm talking about the phone. Is that a 7?
God, probably yeah, like
probably.
A seven.
Cart rides in VR.
Wow, I can't
believe that. John Carmack, how far you have fallen really from your awesome. Days at id Software.
I think I'm gonna stay down here. This looks like a good spot to start construction on my mad scientist lair.
Thanks, John.
Oh my
awesome
god, the bad acting is back.
Together. Xbox Live and
guys,
we have bad acting.
Guys, did so Xbox over the years we've kind of screwed around with it.
But before we go,
but I didn't know it's downgrading itself to Ubisoft.
Yeah.
Let's head through this tunnel and take a look.
Well, like at least they didn't.
Don't forget those terrible Kinect
controllers. Cool,
you know, at least Microsoft hasn't hired Blink 182 to do like a live performance.
Except, well, I mean, to be fair, that wasn't during the conference.
Yeah.
Yeah, Bethesda gets points for not having that part of their conference like Ubisoft does at least. Oh wow, look at this big old city.
Jump down to the rooftop
and take a look.
That guy, is he One Punch Man?
Oh shit.
Is that One Punch Man?
Change
no.
Mobs and animals into something
it looks like it.
That's what he's wearing
new.
Right now.
The aliens on the rooftop used to be zombies. But
no, but just like
them,
the face looks like One Punch Man,
tougher.
Where he's just not...
Oh no, Sax, do they
doesn't
have
any expression.
I'm coming over to help.
Wait, you can mod enemies? That's kind of cool.
We've changed the villages too.
Yeah, I think that's part of like the skin pack or the special world or something.
Suits, and we tweaked their AI so they're brave enough to fight aliens with us.
So Lydia, now that the villagers are helping us,
why don't you
let's
have
go
guns.
Over and deal with the UFO.
Awesome, let's head to the redstone cannon.
Alright, I'll be right behind you.
She can't do it. She can't
no,
do
she
it.
Can't, she literally cannot do this with a straight face. It's kind of funny.
If you go over and fire the cannon.
Wow.
Alright, ready? Redstone and TNT, what could possibly go wrong?
They like,
she's
they
fucking
cannot...
laughing. She's like, this
guys,
is so terrible.
We can all do better than this.
Oh, but shit, look at that big explosion.
We can all do better than this. Seriously.
Yeah.
Hey!
Saxus said it best. Let's get out of here.
Please.
We hope you enjoyed this early look into how you'll be able to change your game. It's just a first step towards a fully moddable future for Minecraft. Add-ons will come to Minecraft Windows 10.
So hey man,
iOS,
you think
and
we're still gonna get paid after that?
We're also working hard to bring add-ons and realms to Xbox and consoles next year. Until
oh,
then,
boy.
Download the friendly update with Realms and Xbox Live.
You mean
anyone
when nobody
with
cares
Xbox
about
them? Xbox Live account can sign up right now and try Realms for free on your phone, tablet, or Windows 10. We have more news and new surprises for our community at MineCon in September. Thank you.
MineCon.
Why did she look at him?
She's probably like signaling to kill her now.
I'm gonna kill everything now.
A new controller. Oh wait, what? What?
Custom controller.
They already. Oh. That's kind of interesting. Except, guess what? Companies have been doing this for years, so it's literally one of those things.
Oh, look at all
where
those fucking colors, guys.
It's yeah. literally one of those things where another company has
make
done
it,
and they're like, hey, we actually want to do it, charge people. We want to make money off
hey,
of this
man.
Idea.
Make this controller your controller.
Make this controller.
Make it personal.
I mean, that's kind of cool, but how much Doctor more expensive
Who.
Is
Doctor
it?
Doctor Who!
Pit
what
Bear,
the fuck?
Storm Yeti.
So I can get
Pit Bear, Storm Yeti. Wait, what are the other
things?
Oh, I can't even see it. I can't see it.
Oh, look at all the colors. I can't handle it.
Can I literally make a Rainbow Dash controller?
I was about to make a Rainbow Dash reference, but I'm glad you're the one that made it.
Well, I would have slapped you anyway, so.
Alright,
let's
go.
Hey, see. We got
oh
some. Crazy shit. That was just
future.
Game.
What I mean by slap, I mean like
I think
future.
This is that one game
future
by the
slap.
People who made Limbo.
From
yeah.
the creators of Limbo.
Isn't it like something?
Indie other? Games. I guess we can check off indie games. That was the thing, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, indies. Yeah. I think I'm a little behind for some reason. If they mention HoloLens, we get double bingo.
Yeah.
I want one of these days, I want it to just be like, we got all of the fucking slots.
Yes. I'm surprised we haven't
that
yet.
That will be the ultimate predictable.
Oh, okay. So if we get HoloLens...
Inside, available June 29th. Apparently.
Guys, if we get HoloLens
or Long Dead franchise comes back and doesn't suck, we have triple bingo.
Oh man, Chris Charla.
Hey everybody.
Oh, this guy.
So, one of the coolest parts of my job is that I get to play a lot of games before they come out. Shirt. I've gotten to play Inside, and I can honestly say it is a masterpiece. It is one of the best video games I've ever played, and I can't wait for everybody to get to try it when it launches.
Oh, it's literally at Xbox.
Playdead's first game, Limbo, is
going to
be
free
on Xbox One. Players on Xbox One starting today.
Oh yeah, Reddit already debunked that.
You know,
Reddit already did that.
Developers have fundamentally changed the way we play games this generation.
Oh man.
Bringing unprecedented diversity and fantastic experiences to players around the world.
I mean, they already made their money on Limbo, so.
1,000 games in development for Xbox One and Windows today via the ID at Xbox program.
What,
we're really
thousand?
In a golden
really?
Age. Let's take a quick look at
some 1,000 what?
Are they any good?
There's 1,000 games. Only 1,000 in development for Hey Cuphead.
Yeah. Oh. Okay.
We only showed like a couple seconds of Cuphead.
Oh, we don't have a montage for this one. Okay, while this montage is going on,
Yay,
I'm gonna
Cuphead.
Yeah.
I'm gonna sync up again.
Can Xbox play any
Outlast 2.
I'm syncing up. There we go.
There's Outlast 2, Zane's hometown.
All right, I'm I think I'm with you guys now.
All
right. Slime Rancher.
Yeah, Jacksepticeye can't play that.
Shadow
Tactics.
So are any of these just Xbox?
The Calling!
Yay! That game I have only played like three times.
That game that runs 10 frames per second
Stardew
is Stardew
Valley.
Valley.
That game
and
that Stardew Valley too.
Below.
Below. Oh.
Chucklefish is the one that made Starbound, the
game
that kind of died a little bit.
Kinda like it.
Raiders.
Okay.
Bloodstained. Yeah.
Ukulele.
Ukulele.
Neverspace. Risk takers.
Rule breakers.
Game changers.
Yeah.
You guys are like a few seconds behind me.
Yeah.
So it's like Vince somehow knew what they were going
to
say.
Know, it has been awesome to see the incredible creative and commercial success independent teams are having on Xbox One. With multiple million sellers and hundreds of millions of dollars in revenue going to independent studios. One game that's already broken the million seller mark is Ark, Survival Evolved from our friends at Studio Wildcard.
That game,
oh dude, look at how flat
Ark
it was.
On Xbox One,
it's like the game that runs at like 14 frames a second
PCs
on Xbox
fall,
One.
At no additional cost.
Yeah, I actually deleted it because it just kept updating.
Hey, Xbox Play Everywhere is giving
pretty cool.
Fucking.
Oh man.
So,
yeah, make that
a
feature instead
preview.
Of optimizing
it's a
program
it. That enables players to buy and play games while they're still in development and offer feedback to the creators. The program has been a huge success.
You mean like Steam is already doing?
Yeah.
And we're excited to have a lot more games.
I can't play
Slime
Xbox
Rancher, The Culling, Everspace.
No, but I'm saying like they're saying they're basically saying early access.
Guillaume Provost from Compulsion Games to come up on stage and show off a project that's going to be launching into Xbox Game Preview next month. Guillaume?
Oh boy.
You know, to be fair, guys, we're actually talking.
We have a view!
Hey.
Yeah.
We're actually talking less than we usually
happy
do.
Happy people have no history.
I'm not happy then.
Oh, heavens no.
What is this?
Oh man, redacted.
Oh, God.
Oh. Holy shit, he's going
what?
Down.
Wait, what?
I don't know.
I don't know what he was saying
I'm
that
about
to.
Hey, Friday the 9th of October in 1964. Oh shit, he's gotta take pills.
I'm confused.
I'm confused too. Take the pills.
We have a few.
Yeah, we have a few. We have a few, they take pills to make the
buy pain. Your victory against communism. Oh, fuck the pills. Buy your victory against communism, do it.
Percy! Percy!
Save now, rejoice later.
I don't understand what changed.
No one's seen you for hours.
His pills wore off. Most of the pills that make him happy.
You know.
Then why haven't I heard a single whoosh through the door since 10 o'clock? Did you forget we're having Deirdre's birthday party? Oh. We've got a pinata.
Right.
Hey, look at the pill on the. She's looking at
We've got a pinata.
Have you forgotten your joy?
Take the pill, boy.
Of course not. Snug as a mug on a drug.
Well, come on then. Finish up.
Just have a few more pages. I know you're very busy.
Then don't take too long to finish.
Oh, she'll take the pill.
Oh, she just... Wow. Whoa. Okay. Don't dawdle. Okay. I didn't need to see that. I did not need to see that. That is Zane material right there.
What? Her fucking smile?
Yeah. Like, just that immediate creepy...
Do you think the canister wonders what life's just, like outside the tube?
Game
of course, we'd have to break the tube to get out. I will break it for everybody.
What is this? Do we? Oh, we happy few.
Yeah.
This is actually kind of interesting. Actually, I might play this.
You're not coming back, are you?
First on console on Xbox One.
Yeah,
so
first
it's
gonna
come to PS4 later.
It's already on PC.
Yeah, that doesn't really bother me. I can wait. I can be patient.
Oh shit!
Not so happy anymore.
You need the advanced happy medicine.
Advanced.
Oh shit.
Vince, this isn't just happy medicine. This is advanced happy medicine.
Oh shit, it's like the fucking combine scene at the beginning of Half-Life 2. Yeah, there with that guy.
I still need to finish Half-Life.
I need to finish Half-Life 2.
I don't even remember where I am. I'm like a few sections away though. Whoa. I forgot. That's right. That's the next game I need to play after I beat. After I
there you are.
Recently
you
beat.
Oh shit! Yeah, beat the pinata. Beat it happily. Spanish custom.
Uncle Jack did a whole show about. That's it. Not how you pinata, guys.
Really not.
That is not how you pinata.
Hit it! Hit it!
What even is that? Is that supposed to be a freaking?
They gotta smash the happy out. I bet he's gonna hit it and happy pills are gonna spill out.
No.
Oh shit!
Holy.
No.
Whoa.
Okay.
I knew it was rare that I was
squished. What the?
Okay.
You are off your joy. Take one of mine.
No. No.
What?
Oh my lord.
No, screw
He's
it.
A downer. Call security.
No.
We got a downer.
Fuck that. Hey man, and if being a downer means I'm not gonna be tricked into eating a dead mouse that I just busted open.
That was like that was like almost park material for me.
Yeah, fucking pipe that bitch.
That was almost park material.
Oh. Available.
And that's
on Xbox
saying
Game
a lot.
Review.
That is
Look
saying
at that
a
smile.
Lot.
Look at that smile.
Nothing will beat the park, but it'll get pretty close.
Oh,
just
man.
So you guys know, the park is the one game that even made Zane uncomfortable.
That was great. We're so excited to be working with such incredible creators.
And yes, I played the park.
And we're super
for some reason.
The Xbox players
dumb.
There are only two people in this group that have played the park full,
and
that's
up,
Zane and me.
A very cool new game from a very
complete opposites of the spectrum.
CD Projekt Red.
Hey, CD Projekt Red.
We got kids.
It's the Gwent trailer.
Gwent.
The card game?
Oh man.
So
Witcher 3 Hearthstone standalone.
So card games, guys. Card games on motorcycles.
You are the wild card.
Lead designer Damian Monroe.
You know what, Vince? You know what? I foresaw this in my Ninja Info cards.
Oh man, this guy's so fucking excited. Look at him.
I'm glad you're the one that brought that back, Ryan. Now Zane's gonna be mad at you.
After we release Witcher 3.
But card games, like, you didn't think that would come up?
Players took a lot of time to just sit down in taverns and play cards.
I was just surprised you guys
were so excited about the card game that they sent us thousands of emails asking us to turn it into a standalone. And
kinda
some of our
most
inspired fans even made their own physical decks.
Oh, Matt, this has nothing to do with Xbox. But guess what aired a year ago?
And over the last year, we've been
episode 100.
A real passion project.
Yeah.
So, Ladies and gentlemen, how about a game of Gwent?
Oh boy, let's play a game of Gwent.
Awesome. Card games?
We've turned Gwent into a full-blown multiplayer experience, and thanks to its cross
like card games have been around since the dawn of time, but I don't know why we're starting to do digital card games.
Hearthstone came around and people were like, hey, that's popular.
It's like, yeah, it's like another freaking Skylanders thing.
Kept the core mechanics that made Gwent fun.
Because like, you got Skylanders.
Is Blizzard like actually the company that everybody wants to copy? Almost completely.
Well, actually, however, which was first? Was Amiibo first or was Skylanders first?
Skylanders.
So it was Skylanders, Amiibo, Disney Infinity.
Oh yeah, Disney Infinity, cool. Lego Dimensions.
And then Lego
Gwent
Dimensions, yeah.
It's a clash of two armies on the battlefield, basically. And our fans love the fact that you only get 10
and
cards at the beginning.
What was
of the game,
it? So it's Hearthstone. So you have then
you have
Legends, then Gwent.
In some cases, you may even not want to lose a round in order to take the game.
Or is there one I'm forgetting?
Your deck is the army that fights for you, an army
like,
you recruit from
Rabbids is getting
four
a card
factions,
game, isn't it?
Oh, okay, that too.
Playstyle and different tactics
then
as well.
So yeah, so it's just like Skylanders, there's four of them.
And their mighty berserkers, yeah. Northern Realms and their powerful siege engines, the shadowy, sneaky Squirtle, and of course, the nasty, brutal monsters. As you win
monsters
and craft new cards,
see,
time,
I don't really know how exciting you can make
to
virtual cards.
Your in clever ways. Because at the
like,
end,
not very.
Because there's no animation
so,
or anything. It's literally just a mobile game.
To register for the exclusive beta, available first on Xbox One and
I mean,
beta? PC,
like
and it's coming this September.
Guys, sign up for the beta. Woo,
not long to wait. Thank you all, and of course, thanks to my amazing dev team back in Warsaw. I know you're watching us right now.
Yeah.
Kisses. Love you guys. See you all at the Gwent table.
This guy is super fucking
so
hyped.
This guy is super hyped.
Tekken.
This guy is super hyped.
Oh, yeah. Tekken 7.
And it's a contrast from the Minecraft people.
Tekken.
Oh, my God. Not again. No.
Yeah.
Matt, you gotta do your voice.
What's his face? Oh, God. Guys, you saw it here first. Matt Hachi is back.
Matt Hachi is back since PlayStation All-Stars.
Oh, shit. Come on, Hachi.
Time to live it out like Cross Tekken again.
You can kick his from Sassy Hachi. Oh, shit.
Oh, you think you're tough, you son of a bitch? Fuck you! Headbutt, motherfucker!
So, Matt, you know what I'm reading from you? This is a cross between Brobble Guy and freaking Brobble Guy and Ryuichi. Or maybe it's just Ryuichi, I can't tell.
Oh shit, no, come on, Hayashi, kick his ass.
What? Is somebody playing this?
Thanks for cutting away, guys. That was kind of stupid.
Yeah, gameplay. Oh, what the fuck?
Is this a live demo? Can you tell?
I think this is a live demo.
Oh, fuck you!
They just both healed themselves?
Yeah, they just healed themselves.
Oh, yeah.
Guys, we have unlimited time.
This gameplay is cinematic.
Kuma, you bitch, I'm going to kick your ass.
Oh, yeah, get him. Yeah, do it.
Too late, motherfucker!
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah!
So, like, do they plan out who's gonna lose?
Probably.
It hurts you never lose.
Oh, shit, he's up like lightning.
That was not lightning.
Or die a thousand deaths!
I will
Whoa.
Die, you fuck! Miss
Such power. Much power.
You identify yourself.
Doge. This is the game of Doge. Much power.
Oh shit. Oh snap.
Tekken 7.
Early 2017.
Is there a reason for another Tekken, or just cause?
Just cause.
Today, Tekken 7 is coming to Xbox One.
This guy looks like he gives zero fucks.
Yes.
Yeah, you'd be right.
Is that Japanese?
The guy on the right gives zero fucks, and the guy on the left is white.
Not only will Tekken 7 evolve as a competitive fighting game,
is that Japanese?
Yeah.
There is an all-new story mode that transitions seamlessly from epic narrative cinematics to action-filled gameplay.
I wish I could do something like that.
I can't wait for the story mode. That confirms the fact that Tekken and Street Fighter used in the same universe.
I wish I could be a translator.
I hope you all are excited to hear more info coming soon on story mode.
I mean, without the work.
Features we have planned for the game when it ships in early 2017.
Like, have you seen the picture that says when you go to Japan and there's no subtitles?
Yes.
Yeah. I can't wait until technology with like Google Glass or something enhances enough to where you can literally go to Japan and there's subtitles everywhere.
Free Tekken Tag Tournament 2 for Xbox Live Gold members.
That's coming at some point. That's coming at some point. Just subtitles everywhere.
They made an earpiece that like can understand what people are saying and translate.
Right, yeah, but you can't talk. You can't
this
say
is
it
Dead
though.
Rising.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
So I'm gonna go ahead and mark it, but I don't agree with
it's Dead Rising. Look at that.
Oh, confetti. Camera.
I'm gonna mark it, but I don't agree with the rest of the square because it says nobody asked for it, but I kind of asked for it.
Yeah. I'm always down with some more Dead Rising. Also, I love the Christian music.
Yeah, we already knew this was gonna happen because they this entire presentation leaked on the internet.
Yeah, welcome back, Frank West. Frank is back.
Woo! So we can get triple bingo or quadruple bingo if we have something dumber than the car being on stage last year.
The Minecraft presentation was dumber than the car being on stage.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Electric bumper car.
So we're not copping out for that. That's legit.
No. Yeah, I'm sure. It's pretty dumb.
This looks pretty fucking insane.
I'm gonna hit you with the. Wait, is it Christmas? Cause it's gonna come out holiday.
Yeah, probably.
You know what, probably. Oh man, I can't wait to fucking breathe fire in Dead Rising 4.
You know, Vince, we still need to play more Dead Rising 2.
Yes.
Holiday 2016.
We haven't played since my birthday in like 2014. Publishing,
Shannon Loftus. Something like that.
Hey Shannon, how are you?
Hi Shannon.
Gamer Sunset Overdrive. Is all about moments. Remember the adrenaline rush you had as you air dashed hundreds of feet above a mutant infested city? Or surviving
No, because I haven't played the game yet.
Of a beloved character. Or in the Blind Forest.
Oh, I need to play that at some point.
Between best friends turned epic enemies.
Depends on how much on sale it is.
At Microsoft Studios Publishing, our mission is simple.
Remind me to get that. I need to get that.
To all of our platforms by working with the most creative, innovative developers in the world.
Zachary shit!
We have introduced 13
That's totally
brand
Xbox
new
related.
Originals.
I don't care.
With
it says I still
woo
woo
moments,
woo.
We are
yeah!
a rich portfolio of new games.
Matt, this is the WWE chat.
Storytelling ideas from leading edge creators.
Matt, this isn't the WWE chat. This is the E3 chat.
I want Zack Ryder to just step out on stage for Microsoft and announce an exclusive edition of WWE 2K17 with Zack Ryder on the cover.
Yeah, good luck with that. Good luck with that. Can we not, please?
Do you want to see the creepiest?
Sometimes the games are reinventions of familiar titles, like Killer Instinct.
I'm gonna show you the Golden Truth.
The next few games represent some of the best ideas brewing at Microsoft Studios, and it's worth noting that these games.
Guys, you couldn't have said this during the Forza.
And Forza Horizon 3 will all be part of the Xbox.
Well, then again, they're not directly talking about Sunset Overdrive.
The next time you're in the middle of
level, but so that means Sunset Overdrive, PC.
Sunset Overdrive PC confirmed.
pick it up again on your Windows 10 PC.
Wait, did they actually say it's coming to PC?
Yeah, because all the games that they just showed are with Play Everywhere.
To show you the latest gameplay for one of our biggest
Sunset Overdrive
in 2017, Scalebound.
Yeah,
how much is
Sunset Overdrive
right now?
It's my honor to introduce legendary creative director of Platinum Games, Hideki Kamiya.
Yeah, Platinum Games. You guys have been putting out the quality games lately.
Except for Mutants in Manhattan, but you know.
He's like almost Hideo Kojima.
As a game director.
Like his name is.
I have the chance to share my dreams. I have always wanted to play in the world.
Fucking glasses. Hideki Kamiya, you're such an asshole on Twitter.
Giant beast.
Yes, he is.
So much emotion in that face. Just so much.
Those fucking sunglasses.
So much emotion in that face.
Xbox One and Windows 10 exclusive.
Hey, another
Scalebound has a
live
PC
demo.
Version. Yeah.
Wonderful.
Hey, it's the older version of the Young Dante.
So every time they say and Windows 10, it's just like more solidifying the fact that I'm just like, yay, I don't need an Xbox One.
Yeah, look, co-op.
Oh, Scalebound. Like
yeah, but is anybody else playing with him?
Against all yeah.
Yes.
Oh, there he is. Okay. No, there's three people playing.
There's four people.
Oh, there's the. Oh, hi. I didn't see the other one.
Yeah, you show him, Dante.
Hey, everybody, copy down their names and try to add them. Not.
This is Shadow of the fucking Colossus.
It is
all over
apparently
again.
Called Thuban.
Too far from my bow.
Oh man, it's the spider boss from the first Devil May Cry.
Those arrows aren't hitting anywhere.
So this actually looks pretty cool.
Scalebound. Hey, the frame rate looks stable. What do you think, man?
They're probably playing on PC, though.
That looks alright to me.
That's probably on a heavily equipped PC, though.
Scalebound is Xbox Play Anywhere.
Yeah.
Right, Zane?
Maybe? Probably.
Like, that's what I'm thinking, because I doubt that.
Just for the purpose of making sure this goes smoothly, probably.
Yeah. I doubt it. It's an Xbox One.
Oh man, that thing's almost dead.
But Scalebound finally has a stable frame rate is a thing.
Murder its ass for free.
Oh, did it not?
Yeah, I didn't have one last year.
See, it doesn't look like those arrows are doing anything.
Because they're not.
Oh shit. It's Crusher.
Snap, Crusher!
It's doing like one damage each. Holy crap.
Oh, that arrow didn't do anything. Not
good. Cupcake plays?
Yeah, Cupcake plays. Oh shit. Oh.
They couldn't even get the name, so they had to add a zero.
Yeah, Devil Trigger.
I'm
this
guessing,
really is
I'm
Devil
guessing that's
now.
The girl. I'm guessing that's the girl. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. Gender identity. Maybe it's the guy.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm sorry. That was unnecessary.
Man. Wow, Ryan. Way to gender stereotype people.
That was unnecessary. I'm sorry.
What the fuck?
But, like, seriously, our world right now is just stupid.
Yes, it is. Is.
Like, whenever I make jokes like that, I don't mean to be insensitive. I'm totally kidding, but, like, my gosh. By the way, why is he even wearing headphones? Because they're probably already screwed up by now.
Yeah, if any of you get offended, that you didn't realize nothing happens if you're offended, right? Like, you don't get left.
Attack the brain. Hit its weak spot for massive damage.
I'm guessing those are waterproof headphones.
Probably.
Those have got to be active headphones.
Oh, the music kicks in, guys.
Yeah.
Hey, look, it's a
yeah, with my arrows that do nothing.
Why do you have
the arrows? They do nothing.
Hit the exposed target on its head.
They're not that smart.
I mean,
actually, I don't even think that's exposed. I think that's shielded.
Oh man, this music is some hype shit.
Hey, look, Shadow Colossus.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Wow. That is Shadow of the Colossus.
Yeah, you punch that exposed meat.
Jeez, how long has it been already?
Not 90 minutes.
Because I need to take a shower soon.
Started 7 minutes early, so it's only been like... We still have like half an hour, 15 minutes maybe.
Jeez.
Yeah, do it. Double trigger. Yeah, got it.
Yeah! Wait, they attacked its weak point for massive damage, and guess what this is?
Yeah.
It's a fucking
giant
crab. Giant
fucking crab, wow!
And they're doing the same thing!
Oh. Scalebound available 2017. Xbox Play Anywhere. Xbox
One. See, I really like this idea! Cause, like, we can play all of these games.
Oh shit, another game. Oh, a Sea of Thieves!
So... Oh, they had a thing! Sea of Thieves had a thing. It was, Sea of Thieves details.
Fine, yeah. Alright, so we got Scalebound, had a stable frame rate, and Sea of Thieves details.
So I guess a detail, I guess this counts as details. So... Oh, wait! Yep! Guys, we have double bingo now!
Wow.
Yeah.
Because of Scalebound.
Seriously, way to be predictable, Microsoft.
We have double bingo because of Scalebound. And we'll almost have, guys, we'll have quadruple bingo with HoloLens.
I don't think we're gonna get to see HoloLens. Which is unfortunate.
Oh, look at all the pirate stuff.
Look at all the booty!
So, I think in the future, like next year, we'll probably not crap on Microsoft as much just because we'll be able to play all these games anyway. So this is kind of the year where we're kind of neutral now. Which I never thought was possible.
Sea of Thieves. Yeah, Microsoft kind of just pulled themselves back after that one horrendous E3 they had. Where they like announced the Xbox One. From Rare,
well, I mean, the fact that we don't have to buy anything additional is awesome. I just don't know how well it's gonna work out. Because, like, the games are gonna be specifically made for the Xbox One, so...
Oh, Studio Head of Rareware, your company has fallen so hard. In Sea
of Thieves, like, can you see the sadness in his face?
Explore rich worlds in search of hidden treasure.
Can you see the sadness?
I can see the emptiness in his eyes.
Like, he's like, I really wish it was still 1995.
Look, there is sadness in his eyes.
He seriously wishes it was 1995 still.
Ryan, he's wearing a Goonies t-shirt. You have never been more right.
I'm excited to show you a world premiere of Sea of Thieves gameplay.
Just the sadness. Like, he wishes it was, like, 92 still.
He's just standing there, and in his mind, he's thinking, you know, my company made Banjo-Kazooie, and now we're working for Microsoft.
To play our game. We put them into three
crews. I bet
he's
wondering, how much press would I get if I shot myself in the head right now?
No, you know what this made me think of, Vince?
What's that?
I wonder
real gameplay, as opposed to the fake gameplay all other games have. Real players.
As opposed to bots.
Great water.
Great water!
Let's.
You know what? All of the games have terrible, shitty water.
You know what? We actually commented on that yesterday.
Alright,
it was like, all games have good water nowadays.
Oh, hello!
Very good, Bobby, really? That's a terrible name.
Stay back. You foul.
Oh, Nat and Ninetales.
There we go, see? That's so cool.
They already have better acting than the Minecraft.
Are these celebrity personalities?
The main
mass
sales still need to go down.
I do have to say, the game definitely looks really good.
But no, Vince, I was gonna say, I wonder if the hype from this stage is enough to kill me.
Are we emptying it?
Oh, Sprinty John.
I don't know, I can usually walk a straighter line than this.
Are these YouTubers or something?
Oh, you're fucking drunk. I don't know.
I don't recognize any of these people. But to be fair, I wouldn't
I wouldn't recognize
anybody, to be fair, other than like Achievement Hunter people, Markiplier, and Jacksepticeye.
Okay, so the sail's blocking my vision, so you're gonna need to tell me where to steer.
This is mine.
Shut up.
I have a feeling that's Vince. Guys? Hey, Captain's Quarters, this is all mine.
All mine. Oh my god. Forever. Oh shit, go to the boat. Are you about to get fucked?
Set the sail! You're leaving me behind!
No! Oh no!
Oh, this is what someone would totally do in our group.
That's Vince.
I would probably just be on my own boat doing my own
thing. Hey guys, look, slide 3. Look guys, slide confirmed. Now you can shut up.
Slide 5 confirmed, guys.
Yeah, Zane, you would be doing your own thing on your own boat where you'd have to steer the ship and shoot the cannons at the same time.
And then just I would like probably three. Still beat you. Just
you know how to repair it? You hit it with a cane.
Oh no, yeah, and you have to repair the ship when it gets shot too.
See, no, Zane. All Zane needs is a PS3 controller and a cane. That's it. Because
so,
you can steal the boat with the L2 and R2 buttons. Did he literally make that joke?
No. To the left, okay, to the you know left. Why I would win?
Oh my god.
Because I would not prioritize my own safety. I would suicide mission if it meant beating you.
Xbox One.
Wow. Windows I don't think exclusive. That's true in the wake of the moment. What yet.
Hey. What's this?
It's an exclusive only for like a year. What but we won't tell it? You that.
Oh. Is this Mafia 3?
What
3?
Is this?
Uh-oh.
It might be. And I'm stoked if it is because I can't wait for Mafia 3. I already
See,
got it for
I don't
30
think
bucks!
It's, no, but... it's not Mafia 3.
No, there's no
Oh song. Man, is this Dead Island 2?
Maybe?
I thought that was canceled.
Yeah.
No,
yeah,
it's
it
Twitch
canceled.
Developers.
I'm making a joke. No, it's canceled.
Not Jack exactly. But kind of.
And that's how you stop for
is
gas.
This, is this that? Is this Left 4 Dead 3?
No.
Yeah, no. Yes. But kind of looks like it.
Wait.
It probably is, isn't it?
No way.
No.
No, it's not. It's something else.
No, it's not. It's what? What is that? What is this?
Oh, is this H1Z1?
State of Decay?
I heard about the State of Decay thing happening. Like,
what is this? I don't recognize that symbol.
Is this like State of Decay 2?
Whoa, jeez.
Oh, fucking brutalize that zombie. Oh no, someone died. Oh shit, that zombie's like hardcore.
Nobody survives alone.
Do they though?
State of Decay 2. Oh man, get that crowbar. Yeah, Zane, nobody survives alone.
Yeah, nobody Zane.
I mean, nonsense. That's what a suicide mission is.
State of Decay 2.
I don't need to win. You just need to die.
Wow.
Damn.
Xbox
that's
One
brutal.
And Windows 10 exclusive.
Oh shit. They're just pulling off the games now.
So wait, was State of Decay dead?
Oh shit, what is this? Is this Portal 3?
No.
Was State of Decay dead? Oh, okay.
State of Decay was not dead.
Well, when did the first game come out?
Halo Wars 2.
Aw, so it's not Halo 6.
No. It's nothing good.
Holy shit. Oh, get fucked.
Get fucked super hard.
Oh, what the
this
hell?
Guy's just walking like, yeah, hey, fuck this.
Hey, what are you doing, man? That's not. You can't do this. Is this Quantum Break 2? Is this the, like, Halo Wars spinoff of ReCore? This person singing the song is making me thinking of the end credits music for Infamous 2.
You don't need to play those freaking games, man.
Yes, you do.
Well, don't worry, I bet at the Sony thing they're gonna announce the Infamous collection for PS4.
Oh, really?
Oh, well.
You know, right I would put
it Spider-Man.
No, but like, is that gonna be a, like, Infamous
I mean, there's already
have they done that yet?
Yeah, for PS3.
They've done that already?
Yeah, oh. There's a collection you can get. You can get Infamous 1, 2, and Festival of Blood and all the DLC.
Oh, but they haven't done Second Son yet.
No. They haven't done Second Son or First Light yet.
Okay.
Oh man, it's Planet of the Apes.
Honestly, that's kind of what I'd be waiting for. His second son in front. Although, I kind
of
heard...
Too, Planet of the Apes.
I kind of heard those were mixed. Like, some people liked them, and some people didn't really care for them.
Second Son?
Second Son is okay. It is not the best Infamous game.
Know your enemy.
And then First
Light. The gameplay was really good. The story people were at the end.
What about First Light?
First Light is okay. First Light is better than Second Son.
Dan
Ayub.
Because you use the best power in the whole game.
Since the release of the original Halo Wars 7 years ago, one of the top asks from fans has been to continue the adventures of the Spirit of Fire. In Halo Wars 2, the crew wake to find themselves orbiting an ancient alien construct known as the Ark. Here, they face a deadly new faction known as the Banished, and their chief, the Brute Warlord, Atriox.
In Halo's Wars,
Atriox is an entirely new kind of villain in our universe.
Do we still have monetization?
The power of a massive army behind him. And he represents a menace that the crew are completely unprepared for. In partnership with acclaimed developer Creative Assembly, we're proud to bring Halo Wars 2 to Windows
Matt,
10
who are you
and
messaging?
Xbox One I'm on February 21st, 2017.
Oh man, Creative Assembly, that sounds familiar.
You're gonna get shit on because Persona 5 comes out before this.
So, why is the digital ticket this year just absolute garbage?
I don't know.
But, you guys don't have to wait to play Halo Wars 2. We're
they're basically like,
beta
at this rate,
Psychonauts
right should beta just be free.
Oh, come on. Fuck you.
What?
The beta is
exclusive. Let's take a quick look at the action that's coming your way with the beta.
Wow.
We'll see you on the battlefield.
Like, do you guys think that at this rate, Psychonauts should just be free?
Hey, guys.
Kind of.
How many times they've given it away?
Hey, guys, okay. Hey, Halo Wars 2 has been made by Creative Assembly, right?
3, 4, 3, yeah.
Oh, you know what else Creative Assembly made?
What?
Alien Isolation.
Yeah.
Is Bungie just non-existent anymore? Or are they
Bungie doesn't. Nobody owns Bungie anymore. Bungie went off to their own shit.
So they're still doing stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're doing Destiny.
Oh, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I didn't really know who was making this.
Please welcome back Phil Spencer.
Hey, Phil.
Yeah, Phil
hey,
Spencer.
Phil Spencer.
Show off that HoloLens so you can be pretty,
pretty
cool.
Much, pretty much it. 15 years ago,
Microsoft... Is that the same leather jacket
with backwards compatibility? If you do that, I will kill you.
Oh, we boy.
I think they are. What, because after all you did with your freaking
with the built-in ability
modding?
To connect
yes.
together. And that same spirit of invention, connection, and fun inspires us to this day. Now, we see a whole new gaming landscape, one being driven by an unprecedented pace of innovation, transformation,
Zane,
and creativity.
Be ready.
You are leading this shift with the way you play today.
Microsoft's
the console
really
ecosystem
starting to,
is
like,
stronger than ever.
Build the deck up
most
against
of us
Sony
play games
here.
On more than one device, and it's shifting the way we think about gaming. At Xbox,
oh wait, maybe this isn't
to
going where I thought.
A world where you have more freedom and choice to play the games you
7
want.
7 minutes until this is
with
over,
the people
Phil
you want, on the devices you want. A world where you.
Okay,
can
so I thought they were doing
boundaries.
The logo thing with
play without boundaries. Generation.
I thought they were doing the logo thing with backwards compatibility.
At Team
guys,
Xbox,
play without boundaries.
We believe you should have a diverse and expansive library
Team
of games.
Xbox.
So today we
diverse
announce
library
our biggest
games.
Lineup of games for Xbox One and Windows
Ooh,
10,
wait.
Along with
wait.
The Xbox Play Anywhere program that enables you to buy a game once and play it on Xbox
wait.
One and Windows 10.
Are you
we
talking about classic
gaming communities where you can play, compete, and connect with friends? Wherever
United
they are.
Gamers
or is this just a wrap up? Is this literally
just
a wrap
up?
Is available
wrap
for developers
up.
To use
it's
across
lead
Xbox,
into something, though,
Windows
isn't
10,
it?
VR,
yeah.
and mobile.
I don't know, is it?
We believe in gaming for everyone.
A place where gaming is for
are
everyone.
Welcome, respected and supported. So today we announced new Xbox Live.
What is this, an employment office?
You build your network and play your way. And we believe in hardware innovation without sacrificing compatibility. Today, we announced the Xbox One S the new addition to the Xbox One family.
Yay,
it's not a VCR anymore. It's now a small DVD player.
Xbox One family. But that's just the beginning.
Beyond generation.
Wait, opportunities on the horizon. Wait.
Opportunities to unlock new innovation for both gamers and developers alike. The next step change for gamers and developers must deliver true 4K gaming and high fidelity VR.
We already knew that.
To our friends and asking them what they want to see from us. I'm really excited to share what we've been working on.
Oh boy.
Oh god. What is this gonna be?
So not backwards compatibility then.
I'm gonna take a guess and say something with Oculus.
Well, I mean that's one of the bingo stuff.
I'm calling it now.
When we think about the future of Xbox,
what is this? This seems like an ASPCA commercial. It's so serious. Delivering
the world's most powerful. Hey man,
guys,
every day,
guys, adopt our console. Adopt our console, guys, please. Well, he kind of smiled.
And that technology component to us is
oh,
what we
man.
Todd Howard?
Todd Howard.
Our vision and our art come alive.
When I saw the specs of this thing, I'm like, wow. I got true to, like, they're really going for it. They're not holding anything back.
So we gave the SoC 6 teraflops of computing capability to be able to handle 4K resolutions. Gamers are going to get the most powerful graphics processor that's been put into a game console today.
It's going to make developers happy.
Oh,
it's going to make gamers happy because they're going to get a very powerful GPU out of it.
The highest res, the best frame rate, no compromises.
Is this kind of a piggyback thing where you Xbox is like, oh snap, Sony's doing 4K, let's do it too?
Actually do with all that horsepower in the box.
We or do you think it was the other way around?
We can render fully uncompressed pixels. These are the highest quality pixels that anybody is seeing. And what we're
the
able to do now is bring
pixels.
That to the console player.
Pixels for days, Vince.
My job as a game maker is about immersion.
Yeah.
It's about to put you into an experience and let you live that experience. The richer and more accurate those visuals are, the more immersive it is.
And if we can get a lot more performance, and I mean a lot more, like with this, we get to much greater and better game experiences as a result.
We're moving Fallout 4 to VR, and to have a console that can support
that,
the resolution and speed that we really want, I think it's going to be magical.
Is it Oculus?
This console is 100%
magical. This is Disney,
guys.
We
read the articles, we read the reviews. It's the We Heard You console.
So that doesn't mean that we are leaving the original Xbox One behind.
Scorpio?
Every single thing that we've done for Xbox One.
What's Scorpio?
We add to the capabilities of the Xbox One and the Xbox One family without forcing gamers to abandon all the games in the community.
I haven't heard of Scorpio.
These two systems are part of the same family.
Yes.
The games will work on both. The accessories work on both.
But the box we're building is incredible. It's going to have 8 CPU cores, over 320 gigabytes per second of memory bandwidth.
The max.
6 teraflops of GPU power.
Teraflops? That's a thing?
Yes.
What the frick is a teraflop, Zane?
Project Scorpio.
I don't think you want me to explain that at the tail end of a conference.
The most powerful console ever.
Is it like...
It's a computing unit.
Project Scorpio will be the next addition to the Xbox One.
So it's not memory.
And it is ultimately the next step in delivering our vision for the future of gaming beyond generations.
When he stops talking.
When it ships next year, we believe it will be the most powerful console ever built. With 6 teraflops of power,
that's a bold
this
claim.
Is hardware built specifically to lead the console industry into true 4K gaming and high fidelity VR. True.
I don't really say lead because Sony has the same thing.
Quality, premier VR
like, right, Zane, are these like, aren't these the same specs? Or like, are they like a little bit better?
Fidelity
or?
In the hands of the world's
oh,
best.
No, this
creators.
Is going to beat the shit out of the Xbox One.
Xbox One.
No,
Xbox
I meant like
One
compared
S,
to the Neo.
And Project
compared
Scorpio
Neo,
will all be compatible.
Yeah, we don't know much about
Xbox
the Neo
oh,
yet.
I didn't know if some specs came out,
will play
no.
All three.
They've been
no
very quiet about it. All we knew is that it's going to be probably a 4K.
And it's not an E3, though, isn't
Project
it?
Project Scorpio
no.
is a serious.
Yeah, I think it's confirmed that we don't have it.
And we're announcing Project Scorpio today to give our developers and partners the ability to take advantage of that capability now. in order to
realize. I have a feeling Sony's doing the same thing, but they're just being quiet about it.
Games for you.
Because why be vocal about
Today
it when you can
the beginning of
drop, you can knock people's socks off in the process?
A future where we can all play without boundaries. Thank you.
Gaming without borders. Your games.
So nothing backwards. Well, no.
Why are there never montages?
I was hoping Oculus.
I thought there would be.
So they've pretty much given up on the Kinect.
Okay. Oh,
I think
yeah.
it's safe to say.
Definitely.
The Kinect is just gone. Alright, Zane, now that we're at a montage, what's a teraflop?
It's a computing unit for like graphical power.
Oh. See, that just sounds fake to me. That sounds like something Vince made up.
Alright, well, what do you guys think of the Microsoft conference?
Okay, so we didn't rip them as much as we normally do, and that's mainly because we can play all of these games if we really wanted to.
Yeah,
with the exception of, like, the Halo Wars beta.
Not only that, but I think it was actually really well done. I thought it was fine.
There was, besides the Minecraft stuff, it was actually not bad.
Like, honestly, they didn't do anything spellbinding. Like, nothing was like, woo, holy shit, look at this! Besides, like, nothing was, like, really that, like, incredible. But it was still good. It was just so
I think most of it was also because we heard about a lot of this stuff already.
Yeah.
Microsoft was kind of cool. Microsoft couldn't keep a lid on their conference to save their lives. We knew about
They're like freaking Scott Cawthon. There's Scott Cawthon of the console.
Well, that
industry.
Was alright. That was pretty alright.
Well, okay. So I'm kind of thinking in the future that we're gonna probably not try to make fun of them as much, just because they're starting to level out a little bit. Actually, wasn't last year not that bad?
Last year
was pretty alright.
Last year was alright. This
last
year's
year, didn't
a
we
little
say,
little
oh
better.
Man, Sony's got to step up, and then Sony killed it, and then you're like, oh
yeah,
shit.
So they're start. I mean, they're learning.
I think they're very good.
I think they're learning from Sony.
They moved up from the campy bullshit.
And you know, I think they're okay, mainly because you know we don't need an Xbox. But I tell you what, Scorpio's looking pretty good, and I'm kind of wondering, and I know it's probably true, but I'm kind of wondering if Sony's just going to blow that completely out of the water.
I'm wondering. You don't really know. I mean, I wonder if it's going to be as equal, you know?
Well, seeing as, and I don't mean to go back to this, but like seeing as like Xbox One versus PS4, I kind of expect it to. And that's me trying not to be biased. It's just like the specs in general.
Shit.